Good morning, everyone. Today, I explain about the topic of magnitude stress theory. Last class, I will explain two types of theories and calculate the problems. First one, the maximum principal stress and maximum principal strain. Today, I discuss the topic maximum shear stress theory. This theory is due to Guest and Tresca, and therefore known as Guest theory. According to this theory, the failure of a material will occur when maximum shear stress in a material reaches the value of maximum shear stress in simple tension at the elastic limit. The maximum shear stress in the material is equal to half the difference between maximum and minimum principal stress. That means half of difference between maximum and minimum principal stress. Principal stress maximum of and minimum of, these two things between maximum shear stress in the material. If sigma 1 and sigma 2, sigma 3, the are principal stresses at a point in a material, from which sigma t star is the principal stress in simple tension at the elastic limit, then maximum shear stress material is that equal to, that is the formula, maximum shear stress in the material that equal to half of difference of maximum and minimum principal stress. That is the maximum and minimum, sigma 1 minus sigma 2. Half of, that means half means 1 by 2. That is the main concept of maximum shear stress theory. The material consideration for maximum shear stress in a material reaches the maximum value for in simple tension at the elastic limit. Maximum shear stress in simple tension at elastic limit, that equal to half of difference maximum and minimum principal stresses, that equal to up 1 by 2 into sigma star sigma t star minus 0, that equal to of 1 by 2 sigma t star for the failure of material, 1 by 2 sigma 1 minus sigma 3 greater than or equal to 1 by 2 sigma t star, or sigma 1 minus sigma 3 greater than or equal to sigma t star. That is the equation 24.3. See, the maximum shear stress in simple tension at the least limit. See the formula, half of the sigma t star minus 0, that equal to 1 half of 1 by 2 sigma t star for the failure of material. Both are the equal to find the formula for the failure of the material. Sigma 1 minus sigma 3 greater than or equal to sigma t star. For actual design, when some quantity is to be calculated, instead of sigma t star, the allowable stress sigma t in simple tension should be considered, where sigma t equal to sigma t star divided by safety factor. Hence, for design of the following equation should be used, sigma 1 minus sigma 3, that equal to sigma t. That is the equation 24.3 capital E. The equation 24.3 capital A is to be used for design purpose only. When some quantity is to be calculated, it should not be used for determining the failure of material due to maximum shear stress theory. That this problem won't be calculated for design purpose when some quantity is to be calculated. Quantity, only this equation equation useful for calculate the some quantity, not to you calculate the maximum shear stress theory due to material. Take this for example, this problem, this maximum shear stress theory. Another name is Guest theory. Another name is Guest theory. See the problem 24.4 for the data given. Problem 24.2, determine whether failure of material will occur or not according to maximum shear stress theory. Given data taken into problem 24.2, see the problem. Data is taken. Sigma 1 equal to 200 Newton per mm square. Sigma 2, 100 Newton per mm square. Sigma 3, 50 Newton per mm square. And mu, Poisson's ratio 0.3. Same data taken into calculate the maximum shear stress theory. Same data is will write. Same, this is the same data for problem 24.2. To calculate the material failure. Now maximum shear stress developed in the material. That is the formula of the maximum between maximum and minimum principal stress of 1/2 sigma 1 minus sigma 3 into equal to 1/2. Substitute this values, finally got the 250/2 that equal to 125 Newton per mm square. Here sigma 1 is maximum and sigma 3 is minimum. Maximum shear stress at elastic limit in simple tension, got the formula, that is half of the sigma t star, that equal to 1/2 into 200, that equal 100 Newton per mm square. As maximum shear developed in the material is 125 Newton per mm square, whereas maximum shear stress at the elastic limit in the simple tension is 100 Newton per mm square. Hence failure will occur. That is the problem to calculate the failure of material and maximum calculate the within the elastic limit for simple tension. And take another problem 24.5. At a section of a mild steel shaft, the maximum torque, that means tau, 8437.5 Newton meter, and maximum bending moment is 5662.5 Newton meter. The diameter of shaft is 90 mm, diameter of the shaft, and the stress at the elastic limit in simple tension for the material of the shaft is 220 Newton per mm square. Determine whether the failure of the material all occur or not according to maximum shear stress theory. If not, then found the factor of safety. To calculate the maximum elastic limit in this problem, taken into maximum torque already given, maximum bending moment also given, write the given data in this problem, and stress elastic limit in a simple tension, that means sigma t star, that equal to also is given 220 Newton per mm square. Newton per mm square to converts for Newton per meter square into 10 power of 6. Diameter of the shaft, you know that 90 mm diameter, the converts the meter 0.09 meters. At any section, the torque will produce shear stress, whereas the bending moment will produce bending stress. These stresses will be maximum on the surface of the shaft. Let us find the stresses first. We know that tau t equal to 546 t cube t equal to 516 d cube by 2 tau. Tau equal to 16 into that is the stress per shear stress. Capital T means torque, small this is the tau means shear stress. The symbol tau shear stress, capital T means torque. Capital T means torque. To calculate the substitute the formula, shear stress got the value 58.946 mega Newton per meter square. Also we know that M by I equal to sigma B by Y. Sigma B equal to bending stress. This is the formula for bending stress. Sigma B equal to M into y by I, where on the surface y equal to d by 2, taking into account. Finally, got the formula I equal to for circular shaft moment of inertia pi by 4 64 into d power 4. Subtract this value to get the value bending stress 70.735 mega newton per meter square. On the surface of the shaft at any point, the shear stress is 58.946 mega newton per meter square, and the bending stress is 70.735 mega newton per meter square. The principal stresses at the at this point is given by principal stresses are first to calculate the stresses. First one to calculate the shear stress and bending stress, and to calculate the principal stress sigma 1 and sigma 2, that equal to sigma b by b by 2 formula with respect to sr minus root of sigma by 2 whole square plus tau square. Hence equation 3.16 here, sigma x equal to sigma b and sigma y equal to 0. That is the condition equation here 3.16. Take these four values from calculate the principal stresses. Sigma b, you know the bending stress, and tau, you know, calculate the value. Got the value 104.115 mega newton per meter square, and minus value one plus or minus minus gives the 33.385 mega newton per meter square. Sigma 1 and sigma 2, these are the principal stresses in the circular shaft. Hence, the principal stresses at a point on the surface of the shaft are 104.115 mega newton per meter square, and second one sigma 2 33.385 mega newton per newton per meter square, and zero, that is the sigma 3. Now apply the Magnus shear stress theory. Magnus shear stress due to principal stresses, that equal to Magnus stress theory principal formula, and half of a difference between maximum and minimum principal stresses, that is substitute to the formula sigma 1 minus sigma 2 1 by 2 into you know the formula for calculating the principal stress of calculate the maximum shear stress due to principal stress 1 by 2 into sigma 1 minus sigma 2, that is the formula. To substitute the values, got the values 68.75 mega newton per meter square. In simple tension, the stress system is uniaxial. Hence, the principal stresses are sigma t star comma zero comma zero. Maximum shear stress in simple tension, in the formula, one by two sigma t star. Substitute the value, sigma t star value, got the value 110. Mega newton per meter square, that is the maximum shear stress in simple tension. The maximum shear stress due to principal stresses is less than the maximum shear stress in simple tension at the elastic limit. The failure of the material will not occur. See, the main concept of maximum shear stress theory. At the maximum shear stress due to principal stress is less than the maximum shear stress is in simple tension at the elastic limit, the failure of the material will not occur. That is the main reason. Factor of safety at sigma t equal to sigma t allowable tensile stress in simple tension, then principal stress in simple tension will be sigma t 0 comma 0. And the maximum allowable shear stress in simple tension will be 1 by 2 sigma t minus 0, that equal to sigma by 2. Equation 2, equating two equations 1 and 2, get the value sigma t value, and the factor of safety, the formula sigma t star by t sigma t, that equals substitute to the value factor of safety 1.6. Calculate the factor of safety in this problem, this process. This is the examples for maximum shear stress theory. Second theory, I will explain second theory, another one theory, that is the fourth one, maximum strain energy theory. Maximum strain energy theory. See, this is the maximum strain energy theory. This theory is due to is known as Hayes theory. According to this theory, the failure of material occur when the total strain energy per unit volume in the material reaches the strain energy per unit volume of the material at the elastic limit in simple tension. This is in chapter 4 we have stated that the strain energy in a body is equal to work done by the load in straining the material, and it is equal to 1 by 2 P into delta L. This is the maximum strain energy theory. Consideration taken into volume, unit volume, total strain energy per unit volume in the material reaches the strain energy per unit volume of the material at the elastic limit in simple tension. That is the consideration for, that is the main concept of maximum strain energy theory. You know the strain, change in length by original length, or change in diameter by original diameter. You know the formula. Strain got the no units. This is the strain energy formula for a material work done. U equal to strain energy, that is the formula, half into capital P into delta L. That means P means load. The converts, you know the stress formula, load by area, got the P value, load equal to stress into area, 1 by 2 into stress into area into delta E. That means strain energy, small e. See the strain symbol, small e, equal to change in length by original length, and delta L substituted the value E into L, E into capital L, small e, that is means strain into original length. We got the values half into stress into strain into volume, that is the area into capital L, that equal to volume. Strain energy per unit volume half into stress into strain. AL substitute the volume, capital A into L substitute the volume, unit per unit volume. Unit volume means taken into one, got the formula half into stress into strain. That half into stress into strain, stress symbol sigma, strain symbol small e. That is the equation 24.4. For three dimensional stress system, the principal stresses acting at a point sigma 1, sigma and sigma 2, sigma 3, the corresponding strains are E1, E, E2 and E3, where E1 equal to principal strain in the direction of sigma 1. Now, E2 equal to sigma 1 by capital E minus mu by capital E, sigma 2 plus sigma 3. E3 equal to sigma 3 by capital E minus mu by capital E into sigma 1 plus sigma 2. Total strain energy per unit volume of three dimensional system, capital U equal to, you know the formula, half into sigma 1 into E1 into half plus half into sigma 2 into E2 into plus half into sigma 3 into E3. That is the main formula. You know the values, E1 equal to principal strain is in the direction of sigma 1. So substitute the value, sigma 1, E1 equal to sigma 1. E2 equal to, you know the value, sigma 2 by E minus mu by E into sigma 3 plus sigma 1. See the equation, to substitute this equation, see E2 and E3 got the value sigma 3 by E minus mu by E into sigma 1 plus sigma 2, substitute the value. Finally, got the equation 24.5. That is the equation 1 by 2e common 1 by e, 1 by 2e, sigma 1 square plus sigma 2 square plus sigma 3 square, that equal to minus 2, equation minus 2 into mu, sigma 1 into sigma 2 plus sigma 2 into sigma 3 plus sigma 3 into sigma 1. That is equation 24.5. The strain energy per unit volume corresponding to stress at a heuristic limit in simple tension of into sigma t star into small e t star of into sigma t star into, you know, the et star strain due to sigma t star, that equal to capital E, you know, the Young's modulus formula, stress by strain. Got the, see the capital E, stress by strain. You use finally et star, that equal to sigma star t by E. You subtract this value, you got the values sigma t star whole square 1 by 2 e into sigma t star whole square, and another equation for the failure of the material. Final equation substitute this value greater than equal to, that is the condition taken into, see, I will explain. See, the three-dimensional stress system, the principal stress acting on at your point sigma 1 and sigma 2, sigma 3, the corresponding strains are there. See the condition for in this problem. This theory, Ice theory, according to this theory, the failure of material occurs when the total strain energy per unit volume in the material reaches the strain energy per unit volume of the material at the elastic limit in simple tension. The load in straining the material, and it equal to 1 by 2 load into delta L. Okay. Finally, those formulas equal to this condition, failure of material, sigma 1 by 2 e into sigma square plus sigma 2 square plus sigma 3 square minus 2 mu sigma 1 sigma 2 plus sigma 2 plus 2 sigma 2 sigma 3 plus sigma 3 sigma 1 greater than or equal to 1 by 2 e into sigma t star whole square, equating to got the equation 24.7 for two dimensional system. Sigma 3 equal to 0 taken into 3, sigma 3 equal to 0. Hence, above equation become as sigma 3 equal to 0, got the value equation sigma 1 square plus sigma 2 whole square minus 2 mu sigma 1 into sigma 2 greater than equal to sigma t star whole square. That is the equation 24.8. For actual design, that is when some quantity is to be calculated instead of sigma t star, the allowable stress sigma t in simple tension should be considered, where sigma t equal to, you know, the formula sigma t star by factor of safety. Hence, for design, the following equation should be used: sigma 1 square plus sigma 2 square equal to 2 mu minus 2 mu sigma 1 into sigma 2, that equal to sigma t square. That is the equation 24.9. The equation 24.9 used for design purpose only. It is not used for determining the failure of the material due to maximum strain energy theory. To calculate the design purpose only. That means determining the failure of material will occur in this problem, not according to maximum strain energy theory. You know, the within the elastic limit the particular material in simple tension, and apply the maximum strain energy theory to substitute the formulas, the total strain energy absorbed per unit volume to calculate this in this procedure for this maximum strain energy theory. This is the fourth one. You know the formula for sigma 1 square plus sigma 2 square, that equal to 2, that is minus 2 mu sigma 1 into sigma 2, that equal to sigma t square, for the design equation for the maximum shear stress maximum maximum strain energy theory. Another name is Heis theory, maximum strain energy theory or Heis theory. This is the equation for deriving the maximum strain energy theory. To example problem for this maximum strain theory problem 24.7 for the data given problem 24.7 same data is taken into failure of material will occur and determining the whether failure of material will occur or not according to maximum strain energy theory given the data for problem 24.2 same data is given calculate the formula total strain energy per unit volume of the material in the formula to substitute the values sigma 1 value sigma 2 value sigma 3 value also mu value also substitute this values so you got the per unit volume strain energy for the particular material got the value that equal to 1 by 2 e 49,500 that is equation 1 strain energy per unit volume corresponding to stress at the elastic limit in simple tension is given by equation 24.6 equal to 24.6 equation 1 by 2 e into sigma t star square 1 by 2 e into the value 200 volt square that equal to sigma that equal to 40,000 divided by 2 e. Now apply the maximum strain energy that is equation 2. If you compare equation 1 and 2 to find we find the total strain energy per unit volume in the material is more than the strain energy per unit volume at elastic limit in simple tension, hence failure will occur. Hence, failure will be occur. That is the main concept for this problem. Not given capital E, you give the capital E and calculate some value for total energy per unit volume and strain energy per unit volume for simple tension. Finally, two equations we respond, we compare the two equations. Total strain energy per unit volume in the material more than strain energy per unit volume in at elastic limit in simple tension, hence failure will occur. That is the main concept for maximum strain energy theory. See another problem 24.8 to calculating for determining the maximum strain energy theory. This problem I will explain. And now last one, maximum shear strain energy theory. This theory will completed. That unit unit one will be completed. See the problem 24.8. For the data given in problem 24.6, determine the diameter of the bolt according to maximum strain energy theory. Data will be given, load is shear force also given, load is given, and sigma T star is also given, safety factor is also given, mu value, Poisson's ratio also given. Now, Poisson's simple stress in tension, sigma T, this sigma T star divided the safety factor is also sigma T value, got the value, and therefore the other values calculated the problem 24.6 are sigma equal to 11,459 divided by d square. That is the tau equal to 5729.5 by d square, where d equal to diameter of bolt. The formula for calculating problem 24.6. You see the 24.6 for problem. See this problem. The diameter of the bolt in the tensile stress is due to axial pull. So this is the formula for calculating diameter. Tensile stress, that is 11,459 divided by d square. Another one is equation. See tau equal to 5 d square. The two equations for calculating diameter of the bolt. We'll explain the see the problem. This is the diagram. This is the condition for calculating the diameter. The maximum and minimum principal stresses are sigma 1 and sigma 2. The values of say 1 by 2 into sigma, that is equal to, got the value, substitute this value, sigma 1 and sigma 2, and substitute the synergy formula. See, I will explain next class this problem clearly. Synergy theory and explain maximum next derivation part, maximum shear strain energy theory. This is completed for first unit one, and I will give the examples for problems to mainly derivation part practice number of times and calculate the number of problems we practice. Next class I will explain this condition. Next class I will complete the unit two. Sorry, unit one. Unit one completed and start the unit two next class. This topic will completed in next class. Unit one will be completed. Next, I will start unit two. This problems I will explain clearly next class. Thank you. Thank you this opportunity.